Hi students, today again we are meeting together. In this video we are going to see that how basically an Excel works with multiple more options like autofill and many more. So what we have seen in our last previous video on this chapter was simply when there is an Excel window, we have learned what a cell is, what are the different columns and rows, how these columns and rows combine together to form a cell, what are sheets, etc., etc. But in this particular video, we are going to learn a very, very important and very, very attractive feature of Microsoft Excel. Okay, so in this particular video, let us at first discuss about autofill feature of Excel. Okay, so autofill feature in Excel allows you to quickly create a series of numbers, dates or other items that follow a particular pattern. Suppose when there is a particular pattern available, so at that time we need not to write each and everything. Your Excel will automatically fill up all those things by itself. Okay, so this feature is called autofill feature. So using autofill, you can fill the cells using the predefined or user defined series of data. So let us see how it is actually helping that one. So let us zoom this one little bit so that you can see this one. Now let us see, like I'm writing 1 over here, then I'm writing 2. So you can see now that 1 and 2 I have written. Now over here I have selected this one. Now you see this minutely, the pointer, which is right now a symbol of plus, will be changing to a plus with much more thicker and black plus. Previously it was a white plus, now it is black plus. This means it is ready to give you an autofill feature. Now from here you just left click and drag. Once you drag, you will see automatically it is being filled. Now how much you want to fill, it's up to you. I have dragged it so much. See, automatically the data has been filled. This feature is called the autofill feature of Microsoft Excel. This is not like simply 1 and 2. It can do many more such like. So suppose I am writing over here as 1, then I am writing over here as 4, then I am writing nothing. Now see, I am dragging, automatically filling this up. Now you see, automatically Excel predicts that I am jumping with 3 only. So 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 plus 3 is 7, 7 plus 3 is 10. So every time I am adding the previous element with 3 to get the current element. So over here you can see 1, then 4, then 7, then 10. So automatically Excel understands that my range of values should be, you know, always the differences will be 3 only. So we can see that the range of the values are always going according to the previous value, adding with 3 only. So this is the feature where we are going to see that in this manner basically autofill features work. There is many more, like in this kind of patterns, there are many such patterns available. Like suppose I am writing over here as Monday, okay, Monday, then I am writing Tuesday, okay. Now I am just dragging this up. See, automatically it is going in that way. Monday, Tuesday, then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, again starting from Monday, Tuesday. So this is a very, very impressive feature of Microsoft Excel. In that manner, we can see that it can also fill in this way also. Like suppose I have written January. Now February. Okay, let us drag it. It will give in that way only. You can see the series of year is coming one by one. we need not to type each and every, you know, month or day, whatever is required. So this is the most amazing feature of Excel, which reduces our work too much. Okay, so every time it is very hard to, you know, mention the dates or something like that, every time you have to write. So this is here what we are seeing, that we don't require to, you know, type all those things that I require. I can easily drag it up and I can get the value accordingly. So I hope this will help you a lot. One more thing is available, like if there is no patterns, if there is no pattern Excel follows, then it will automatically copy the same thing. It will come like, so suppose I have written 4 and then I have not written anything, so Excel understand nothing. Excel will not think that there will be many such same values, means what to add, what to not add, and what should be the next value. Excel doesn't predict. So for that reason, as I have not written any value after this, so when you put your pointer over there and drag, it will only copy the same thing and it will, you know, display in that way. So this is also an amazing feature. It's all the different features, whatever you have seen right now are all the features of, you know, autofill. So it is an amazing thing which helps a lot when we do a hectic work of typing many things like this. Okay, so this is basically the feature by which we can set the things. Now we are going to learn using fill option. Okay, so we can also generate a series using the fill option in the editing group on the home tab. See, we can also use our own fill options. So let us go in that manner. So at first we'll go to the home group. We are right now there in the home group, and from there we will be going to the editing group. So here is any editing group available? Yes, there is an editing group over here. Now from here we are going to see fill option. This is your fill option. So click on this. Now it will be helping you how you want to fill that, whether right or left or up. Everything is mentioned over here. Now specify the first row consecutive values for the user series. At first you have to specify first two consecutive values. So let us click on this. Just a minute. So let us click on this series. Okay, so you can see an option comes automatically from here, like series according to rows or columns. As basically it is done by columns, I have taken column. Now linear, growth, date, autofill, whatever is there. Now after that you see, select the range of cells to be filled in. So now we have to select the range of cells that we want to fill in. So as I have selected already, 444 is there, so I already have selected. Now click the arrow next to the fill options in the editing group on the home tab. Now you choose the arrow options from here. Basically this is shown according to the, you know, different versions. So this is not the same version, so different things are coming. Now select the series options from the drop down list. The series dialog box has been opened. Now you can see that series option dialog box is there only. Now specify the required options in the dialog box and click OK. So you can see that step value 1 is there, and I have given stop value as suppose 5. Now you click OK. You see 4, 5. Just a minute. Actually this thing is happening due to, you select any of the one from here. Okay, now go and click on the fill option. Now from here click on series. Now according to column it's given linear. Now you know trend will be like this, linear trend, and you click OK. Basically if you click OK with trend value, then it will by default give from start from 1. I'll not go for trend. I'll give a step value as suppose, you know, I want to give the step value as suppose 2 and stop value as suppose 10, and then I'll click on OK. Sorry. Now in this way, from here, if we drag it down, we will get the same value from here only in this way. Okay. So whatever value we will click over here, like I have clicked 1, then after that I have clicked suppose 3. So now when you drag it, you will get the same value like this. So you can see 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. So two options are coming in this way. Okay. Now we are also having one nice option like flash fill. Now what is this flash fill? Flash fill is something which your computer automatically understands when you give a particular pattern like. Okay. So for that, what we need to do, we need to follow some simple step. At first, suppose I am writing some name over here like Abhishek, then I have written suppose Anirban, then I am suppose writing Akhilesh, all names with A. Okay, then I am writing some names with B like Badshah, suppose Bubla, these are all nickname type, any name like this. Okay, now now from here you have to choose that which part of the data you want to select, and it should come in that way. So select that particular cell starting from the, see it's written according to your book. I am going just simply because if I show it in this way, you will not understand. So type the first name of the person in the first cell. Now what to do, select the range of cells to be filled in, including the first cell in which the pattern is set. Now click on the data tab. Now we'll click on the data tab now simply. After that, select the flash fill options in the data tools group. So from the here data tools group, we'll click on the flash fill only. See, okay, just a minute, we'll take some other data from here. Now we'll choose flash fill. See what it has written. We looked at all the data next to your selection and didn't see a pattern for filling in values for you. To use a flash fill, enter a couple of examples of the output you'd like to see. Keep the active cell in the column you want to fill and then click flash fill options. These are just giving information that how these things will work. Basically, you have to do, extract the data from here. And you can do that, like suppose I am writing Abhishek over here. Okay, now if I click this and drag, see automatically the same data is taking. The nature of the nature of this autofill options. Now from here what we will see, we are going to just select the option from here, like I'll write Anirban. Okay, then from here I'll write the rest three options, means including Anirban. I'll take the Anirban also, so I'll take it in this way. Now I'll do what? Now we are simply going to the data tab. Now from here we'll click on this flash fill option. See, automatically other names came. Got it? See, just I have mentioned two names and then automatically other names have came. It has taken the pattern from here. This is what flash fill means. It will automatically predict your data that you are showing. Okay, so after this option, you can see how flash fields are working nicely. Okay, so I think your chapter is already over. So we have already done all the parts of Excel. So regarding Excel, if you have any query, anything to ask for, definitely will go and ask me, and you can ask me in the doubt clearing class, as well as you can ask me in the in my WhatsApp group, whatever you like. Now I will provide one task to you. Just go to your page. I think your page is where. Just go to the page 100. In page 100, you will get some activity zone. Then in the activity zone, you try activity A, B, and C by yourself. And if you face any problem, you can definitely ask me. So your task is the practical task, that is, in your home, open Microsoft Excel and do this one in your home. Whatever task it has been given on the activity zone, that one you will complete. And if you face any problem, you definitely show me. And otherwise, in the doubt clearing class, you can present your screen and show me the answers that you have done from this activity zone. So I hope everything is clear to you right now. So I will wish you all the best for the upcoming half yearly exams, and also do all the tasks that I have given to you, and stay in home and stay well. Okay, thank you all of you. Bye bye and have a nice day.